Hi, and welcome to Franka Emica. In this video, we're going to talk about the main requirements that need to be fulfilled to control our robot via FCI. FCI stands for Franka Control Interface, and it is our low-level control interface to control the robot via a laptop. With this interface, you can use our C++ library called Franka to control the robot. And on top of that, you also have integration to ROS2 and MATLAB. With FCI, you get the robot state, so that is sensor data and further data from the robot at 1 kHz. And you will need to take that data and send back a control command also at 1 kHz. And therefore, we need to fulfill some requirements to be able to do so. A, we need a Ubuntu laptop. For this case, we have a Ubuntu 20.04 installation, and on that we have a dedicated real-time kernel installed. You will find all documentation of our systems in the Franka World Hub. So for FCI documentation, you will find it almost on the bottom of the page down here. And here we also have a section on how to install the real-time kernel. In this case, it's already set up and we have booted in the real-time kernel, which we can verify by typing uname-a in the terminal. And here we can see that we are on the real-time kernel. Next, we need an FCI feature installed on the robot. So this is on the old robot, on the Franka Amica robot. It's a dedicated feature on the new Franka Research 3. It's already part of the system. If we go to the robot desk interface, we're, by the way, currently connected to the ARM interface, to the Ethernet port on the ARM. And we can then reach desk by robot.franka.de. And here we can go to the settings. And under system, we can verify that we have the Franka control interface feature installed. So we can set a tick on this requirement as well. Next up, we will need to take care about our network settings. So to control the robot with FCI, we need to be connected to the master controller. Therefore, we want to set a static IP for both our laptop and the master controller, which we will do in the following. We go to the network settings. We deactivate the DHCP option for our shop floor port, and we can give it an address. In this case, we take 192.168.1.11 and the netmask 255.255.255.0, and we apply these settings. On our laptop side, we also create a new profile by going to the network settings and adding a new profile here, which we can name robot. And we want a manual connection. And we go into the same subnet and give ourselves 0.1.6, for instance, in the same and the same net mask. Now, I will actually switch the connected Ethernet port on the from the ARM to the master controller. Okay, I have now switched the Ethernet cable from the robot ARM to the controller. And now I have to select the robot network here. So we should now be able to ping the robot, or we can also reach desk now by typing our IP address that we have just set up. And of course, we forgot to hand over the control token. Therefore, we will now enforce to get our control token here. Now we're good to go on the network side of things. Next up, we will need the Franka library to control the robot. Therefore, we can go back to the Franka documentation and select the installation on Linux, and we can either simply install it from the ROS repository, or we can build it from source, which we will do now. Therefore, we need to install the following dependencies, which I have already done in this case. Therefore, we will just go to the next step. Depending on your robot system, you will either need to perform these steps for the Franka Imica robot. And in our case, we have the Franka Research 3 with us. We will need to clone the following branch. And we can simply copy these commands, go to our desired folder, and then by hitting Control Shift and V, we can enter these copied commands and execute them here. This will take a few seconds to clone the whole Franka library, and afterwards we can go into that folder and create a build directory. So I will just make a new build directory and go into that folder, and from here we will build the whole thing. We have now successfully built the Franka library. Before we get into it and start executing one example of our library, I want to talk a few words about our new Watchman interface, which we have introduced with the Franka Research 3. If we go to Desk and then select Watchman here in the menu, we can reach our new Watchman interface where we can configure our safety rules. In stock settings, our system comes with two defined rules, which are being watched, the X3.2 input and the X3.3 input. Only if these are closed, the robot is allowed to execute a task or program autonomously. Depending on your scenario, you may need to adapt these rules. For our showcase here today, we have set up one single rule for the work mode, which is monitoring the X3.2 input. Here on our robot, we can see the inputs themselves. We have our standard emergency stop, which always needs to be the X3.1 input, and the behavior of the robot cannot be changed. So if we press this button, the brakes will fall in. And we have our configured X3.2 input. For further information on our Watchman interface, please refer to the documentation, or please refer to the other video where we explain a bit more in detail the Watchman interfaces and how to set up rules. If we go back to Desk now, before we can execute our code, we need to open the brakes of the robot, which we can do here. And we also need to activate the FCI mode. It's worth mentioning here that we need to do this every time we boot the robot and we want to control the robot via FCI. So to activate the FCI mode, we go to the menu and press the Activate FCI button, and we confirm that we want to activate it. So now that the robot brakes are open and we have activated the FCI mode and switched to execution mode on the bottom here, we are good to go to execute some code. To verify that our network settings and our whole setup is correct, we can do one little check that is a simple ping test, which you can find here in the documentation if you go to troubleshooting and then to the network test. We can actually copy this command here and paste it in our terminal. And of course, we need to enter our IP address of the robot here. And for my case, I have to set a comma here instead of a dot. And then we will send some ping commands over 10 seconds and get the results respectively. Here we have some example output. So your round trip time shouldn't be much more than 0.2, 0.3 milliseconds in average. In our case, we have 0.185 seconds round trip time. If you have way larger numbers, you should make sure that you use a good enough Ethernet cable and have no routers, no switches in between. You should have a direct connection to the robot control itself. Now, another thing we can check, and this is actually an example that will initiate motion on the robot, so we will actually have an active control loop with the robot is our advanced network performance analysis. So we simply will execute the communication test. We can just copy this command and paste it here. And at this point, we will enter our IP address. It's worth mentioning at this point, you can also find this in our API documentation, which you can reach by either Google or via Franka World if you go to API docs here. And there you have linked all of our examples of which we will execute the communication test now. You can also find the description of different classes. So for instance, the robot state that the robot will send to your laptop at every millisecond. You can find a description here, which includes all the different sensor data that you can access. Jumping back to our terminal, we will now execute the test. By pressing enter, we need to confirm that we actually want to move the robot. And now the robot will move to a home position and maintain an active control loop for 10 seconds. And afterwards, we will have the results in the terminal here. So we have quite good results. Almost all commands were sent through correctly. So now I want to show you one quick other example where we simply initiate motion. And I want to show you the function of our watchman rule that we defined before. If we initiate the motion here, then our robot will move. If I now activate our 3.2 input device, the robot will come to a safe monitored standstill. That means our code will fail, but we have brought the robot to a safe standstill. And we can, in this mode, also use the assist mode, which is very similar to the guiding mode. So we can move the robot around and we can kind of use this to emulate a similar similar function that we had on the Franka Emeka robot. If we now reset the X3.2 device, we can no longer guide the robot, but now we can initiate motion again. And this concludes our video on the main requirements of FCI. For further information, please refer to our main FCI documentation. In here we will find all information also on the Franka ROS integration, on the Franka MATLAB integration. You will have further information on the available watchman functions on the Franka Research 3. And by that, I want to say thank you for your attention and have fun programming your robot.